Under high pressure, we can measure by using these mechanical gauges. This we are taking in three types. First one is Bowden's tube pressure gauge. Here we are using one tube for elastic tube for finding the pressure value. And next one is bellows gauge. Third one is diaphragm gauge. In today's class, we will discuss about this Bowden's tube pressure gauge. Okay. Let us see how this Bowden tube gauge is working. See one by one. Let us take the first one in mechanical gauges, Bowden tube pressure gauge. It will find the pressure from medium to higher pressure of gases or steam in the boilers or steam turbines like that. This is a simple arrangement. That's why we are using in almost 80% industries for finding the low medium pressure to high pressure. At high pressure, it will give the very correct values compared to medium pressure. So let us see how it is working. Okay. Here we are using Bowden tube. Here we are using one elastic tube. So that's why we are calling this pressure gauge is Bowden tube. Okay, pressure gauge. Here, on which principle it is working? Okay, what is the basic principle of working of this? Let us see. What is the elastic property? This Bowden tube has elastic property. I am showing one example. I have one rubber. So whenever I am applying force, because of elasticity it has, it will elongate or it will deflect. Okay. If I am applying more pressure, it is the deflection is also more. Okay. If it has less pressure, the deflection is less. So this deflection property will find how much pressure I am applying on it. Okay. So deflection is deflection of, this is rubber material. Deflection of rubber is proportional to applied pressure. Okay. This is a basic principle of Bowden tube. Okay, Bowden tube also, it is rubber type material, tube, it is tube. Okay, whatever deflection in this tube, here in example I took rubber, here we can take it is Bowden tube. The deflection of Bowden tube is proportional to applied pressure, which we want to measure it. Okay, if the deflection of the Bowden tube is more, here pressure is also more. So it is connect, this Bowden tube is connected to one dial gauge, so it will show the pressure reading. At one end, the another end we have to apply the applied pressure. Okay, let us see the how the arrangement of the Bowden tube. Okay, here we saw the basic principle. So basic principle means when a elastic transducer is subjected to pressure, it deflects. This deflection is proportional to applied pressure. Okay, so this is the basic principle. Let us see the arrangement, how the Bowden tube we are fixing. First, take this Bowden tube pressure gauge. In it, what are the important parts in Bowden tube? First is Bowden tube. This circular one is the Bowden tube. Okay, black color. Actually, it is in the linear form or lengthy pipe. Okay, or tube. We are fixing this tube, rubber tube, in a circular way. Okay, in this case. Okay, this is called case, metallic case. This is, so that's why it is in the form of circle. We are fixing here for the Bowden tube. There are two ends. Here one end. Here one end. Okay. One end is open here, open tube, inside tube we can send the gas, and here it is fixed one. Okay, we have to fix to this case. Okay, this Bowden tube. The other end is free end. Okay, so it is free here. Now this end is connected to one adjustable link. Okay, like it is the adjustable link. This link, again one end is connected to sector and pinion arrangement. If you see here, sector 1/4 of the circle. Okay, has some teeth on its surface. So this is called sector. These teeth are coinciding with this teeth of the circular one. It is called pinion. Okay. So whenever it is moving, this adjustable link also move. Because of that, this teeth will also move. Because of this movement, this pinion is connected to one shaft here. This shaft also rotate like this. I will show one example how it is moving. Here this is the shaft. This is the pinion. Whenever pinion is moving, shaft is also moving. Okay, like this. Here we have to connect to the shaft one pointer. Okay, whenever this pinion or shaft is moving, this will also move in this direction. It will show the reading on the scale. It is called circular scale. Here we are marking 5 10 15 20 25, like that, in terms of bar or newton per meter square. So this pointer will show the reading. Okay, so these are the main parts of the Bowden tube pressure gauge. Now see the how it is working. What is the working principle of this Bowden tube? Already I told you, whenever pressure of liquid, any pressure liquid is passing inside this tube, okay, it will deflect. It will measure the, that deflection will measure the P value, how much pressure we are applying. okay, in working, first this tube is in the ellipse, in the form of ellipse. This Bowden tube is not perfectly circular, it is in the form of elliptical type, ellipse, okay, ellipse type it is. Now I am sending some gas or liquid, any whatever we want to measure P value, that liquid I am sending inside this. Because of this pressure, the Bowden tube sides, this gas will apply some pressure on the walls of the tube, correct? Now I am supplying some pressure in this tube, pressure gas or liquid in this tube. It will apply some force or pressure on the walls of the, inside walls of the tube, okay? This side and this side, like this. Okay, because of that it is coming in the circular form. Okay, so it is in the, after getting the pressure fluid inside it, it is coming in the circular form. Previously it is in the elliptical form. Now after going this liquid inside this tube, it is coming in the circular form. Okay, so it will deflect in the form of circular circle. Because of this deflection, this will also adjust, this link also has some deflection. Okay, because it is connected here to the link. Okay, now because of this, it will drag this this adjustable link also, sector also. Okay, so this sector will rotate this pinion. Okay, it will rotate the pinion. So because of this rotation, shaft will also rotate. This shaft will rotate this pointer. Okay, whenever pointer is showing going to the on the circular scale, it will give the value of this read, circular scale reading, 5 or 10 bars or 15 bars, like that. So this applied pressure we can find by using this pointer indication on the circular scale because of this deflection of the tube. Okay, this is the working process of Bowden tube pressure gauge. Okay. What are the applications of this tube means? These are using for measuring medium to high pressure. Medium to high pressure we can find. So at high pressure, it is giving very good accurate values compared to medium pressure. Okay, high pressure gas is going inside this, so it will deflect more, so it is giving correct value compared to low pressure or medium pressure. Okay, now what are the advantages of this Bowden tube? Advantages means it is a very simple construction, only one Bowden tube we are using. So it is a very simple arrangement and the cost is also less. If it is simple means cost is less and the working process also very easy. So it can be modified to electrical outputs also. Okay, we can connect to voltmeter or ammeter for showing the readings. In terms of pressure, we can find in terms of voltage, like that. So it is accuracy is more at high pressure. Okay, and some instruments may not work at high pressure. So Bowden tube will give the correct value and the cost is also very less. These are the advantages. Limitations means, so here we had to wait for getting the circular shape for some long time. Okay, whenever gas is going inside this, it will take some time for getting the circular shape, for getting the effect of the liquid inside this. So slow response is there. It is a mainly limitation. Okay, they are very sensitive. If some other vibrations are coming here, okay, mechanical vibrations or some waves, okay, mechanical vibrations of machines, some other vibrations are coming, it is also taking that, it is considering that vibration also in terms of pressures. It is the main limitation. Disadvantages, these are the advantages and limitations of this Bowden tube. But in 90% of the industries we are using this Bowden tube because of the simple arrangement and cost is also very less. In next classes we will see other two mechanical gauges, and thank you for watching this video.